Hi, and welcome to Airplane Arms Navigating Back to School. My name's Lisa Miller. I'm a communications specialist with the Anchorage School District. And today I'm joined by Dr. Kirsten Johnson, Senior Director of Secondary Education. Mm-hmm. Welcome, Kirsten.
Thanks for having me.
Yep, and we are going to talk about all things summer learning for secondary students. We'll just kind of dive right in. If you can give us an overview of what you are planning for this year and maybe how that differs from past years.
Sure, yeah, we're excited to have kids join us again for the summer, especially after being online most of their school year at the secondary level. So we're planning some really robust programs for both middle and high school, face-to-face, in person, at a school building with a real live teacher this summer. And we're gonna be able to offer two sessions this summer where normally we just have one session at high school. So lots more opportunity, and we're able to offer it to middle school students this summer as well. So students that maybe didn't do as well in their classes this year are gonna be able to get back face-to-face and get through some additional learning this summer.
And how are we defining maybe students that didn't do as well? Is that how are you choosing the students?
So at the high school level, it's going to be very much a credit recovery program. So if a student earned a failing grade in any course, they can come this summer and redo that class. So they can get face-to-face instruction and replace that F grade with hopefully an improved grade by the end of the summer. And then for middle school, we wanted to just really kind of give middle schoolers an opportunity. It's definitely a challenging time for kids. So their F grades this year were turned into incompletes with the idea that they would come to school this summer, get a different grade than an F, just much like the high school program, and be able to kind of move on. So if students at the middle school level got an I on their report card, it stands for incomplete, and we would ask them to come to summer school this summer.
Okay, so those are the primary students who will be coming back in, or the first they'll get the first opportunity to attend, are the students who need that recovery for classes that they took over the previous school year.
Yeah, for sure. And then we typically, counselors will reach out to students and parents who have that as a grade and walk them through the sign-up process.
Okay. And when will the counselors be reaching out, and when does summer school start?
So we have two sessions of summer school, one session in June. It starts on June 2nd for students and ends on June 30th. And then a second session that starts on July 12th and ends August 6th. So students are able to attend one or both of them if they have grades that qualify them for entry into our program. And they can take as many credit recovery kind of opportunities as they want during that time. So counselors will start reaching out to families in April, so very, very soon. And we will complete a registration process all through the month of April and into May.
Okay, so the next few months we'll be inviting students, getting them through the registration process. And it looks like there's two opportunities for each block. There's an AM and a PM,
yep.
Is that correct?
Yeah, there is, yeah, okay. Thanks for bringing that up. So students would come for a half day or a full day, depending on how many classes they need to take. And so if a student only has one course that they need to improve a grade in for both middle and high school, they would come for just the morning or just the afternoon. If they have multiple classes, they may come for a full day.
And how many classes will be scheduled into that session?
So it looks a little different at high school and middle school. All of our sites are going to be middle and high school students combined, but they will have different schedules if they're at high school versus middle school. So our middle schoolers will take basically three blocks of time in their day, the first block being a course that they need to improve a grade in. We have some activity-based time put in there, so we'll have some choice time where kids can sign up for whatever kind of interesting, fun activity the school's planning during that time.
That's neat.
So we may have art classes, we may have PE activities, we may have some other fun things for kids to do during that time just to break their day up. and get them moving and not sitting in class for an extended period of time. And then they'll go back to another class before the lunch break. So for middle schoolers, it's broken up basically into three time slots with lunch in the middle. And then the afternoon would start and repeat the same schedule. For high school, they are enrolled in just one class all morning, but the instruction time is going to be broken up within that time period. So they'll be doing a combination of some computer work to address some of the makeup needs that they have to improve their grade. And then the latter part will be more of a face-to-face learning opportunity where they might participate in discussions, they might participate in a hands-on activity like a science experiment, but there will be a combination of computer work and face-to-face activities that the teacher directs.
For the web component, is it the same platforms that we've been using all year?
It's actually a little different. So kids in a normal year this year have been mostly based in Canvas as their online platform. This summer, they'll be working in Apex curriculum, but that's not going to be their whole day. It's just one part of their day at both middle and high school.
And then getting to school and meals and all those logistics, how will that work?
So first, for getting to school at secondary, all of our secondary kids can ride the People Mover bus for free with their student ID. And so all of the sites that we're hosting summer school at have a People Mover bus stop within walking distance or right at the school. So students can take the People Mover from their place that they live and come to school that way, or we are relying on parent drop-off.
And do you have, and what about for meals?
So for lunch, we're going to offer breakfast and lunch at all of our middle school and high school sites. It's also going to be a place where, even if you're not attending school, if you qualify for meals, then you can come and pick up your meals during the summer as well.
Oh, okay. So that's, we did that last summer as well, so that will continue on.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then the program locations, do we have those?
Yeah, so we have three middle schools and three high schools. So Eagle River High School is gonna serve grades 6 through 12 for all of our Eagle River, Chugach area kids. East High School is going to serve students 7 through 12. And then we have Diamond High School, who's going to serve students 7 through 12 as well. And then we also have Bagage Middle School, who is going to serve students 6th grade through 12th grade. We have Hanshu Middle School that's doing 7 through 12, and we have Romick Middle School that's also doing 7 through 12.
So sixth graders, are they included in the, they're all going to the elementary program or the middle school then?
So sixth graders are actually all coming to our program this summer.
Okay.
So it's a little bit different. There's three sites that are going to serve sixth graders this summer, and it just depending on the region of town. So sixth graders still have an opportunity, and they're just, it's at three locations this summer.
And is that, that's also elementary schools where sixth graders are still in attendance, they'd be going to those middle schools?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's a little different than the normal school year. During a normal school year, some sixth graders go to elementary, some go to middle school.
Mm-hmm.
For the summer, all of the sixth graders will be coming to middle school.
And then as far as the locations, are they assigned or is there some, can you choose or how does that work?
So you can definitely choose. So if a parent works in a part of town and it's easier for drop off and pick up at that part of town, they certainly can attend a site out of their location. If something's close to their home, they can do that as well. So it's really a parent choice. It'll be kind of a first come first serve in terms of availability of space. And if a site does fill up, then we would still offer the opportunity, but potentially at a different site.
What about the staff for the classrooms? Are those going to be regular ASD staff who have volunteered for the program?
Yeah, so all the staff we're hiring this summer will be ASD teachers from the regular school year. So many of the, like as an example, Hanshu is a site. Many of the Hanshu teachers may be there, but there could potentially be teachers from service or across town from, West or something like that. So they will all be ASD teachers, but maybe not necessarily all belong to that building during the normal school year.
Got it. And then what about virtual? Because there's a whole nother side of this for different learning opportunities, but it's all online. So can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah. So we wanted to provide an opportunity for families, like if face-to-face attendance isn't a possibility because of travel, or maybe they're fishing this summer and not in the Anchorage area, We wanted to just still be able to provide an opportunity for kids to make up their grades this summer as well. So they are able to attend through ASD Virtual and take online courses. We also wanted to provide an opportunity for kids who want to work ahead at the high school level. So often many of our high school students want to take a course over the summer so that they could take a different course during the school year and work ahead. And so those are opportunities that kids will have through ASD Virtual as well.
And then the dates, and is that the same setup? Is it blocks or is it more just a do at your own pace?
So there's a longer period of time that kids can work in ASD Virtual. So it all begins on June 1st, right after Memorial Day, and will run all the way through August 6th. So students essentially have the whole summer, for the most part, to complete their virtual class.
And the instruction for virtual, is that synchronous, asynchronous, ASD staff? How is that going to work?
So it's all ASD staff again. So ASD teachers will be teaching those virtual classes for the most part. The timeline is at your own pace. So if you need to work at 10 p.m. at night because you're working a summer job as a high school student, you can do that. So there's really no timeline other than the start and the end date.
That's great that we have some flexibility for students who are maybe doing a summer job or going fishing or something.
Right.
For virtual, I see grade improvement and original course completion. Does credit recovery fit into that as well, or is that really in person only?
Yeah, so credit recovery can be virtual or in person, and then original course attempt is all online.
Okay.
So. The other thing I was going to mention that's an opportunity for specifically for our high school kids is if they are working over the summer, like most, and I worked a summer job, a lot of high school students are working a summer job in the summer, they can earn work experience credit for their hours of work. So that counts as an elective credit towards graduation.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So that's an option for kids as well.
Okay. Is there anything else that you wanted to touch on?
I think that the biggest thing I wanted to touch on for summer school, most people are used to summer school at the high school level being very much computer driven. And while that is still an element of summer school, this year we're really trying to change that back to more of a traditional face-to-face teaching kind of opportunity. So kids are engaged, they're getting their instruction from their teachers.
Right.
For a lot of kids, that's really the best way they learn. And they've missed a lot of that this year. So we're really trying to infuse that into our summer program. And for our middle school students, we don't want them just sitting there in front of a computer all summer either. So we've really designed a program where they also get lots of activity, hands-on work. And again, they're not sitting in front of a computer all summer. So we want to get them outside as well. So
very nice. If parents or students have questions, who should they contact?
So if they have questions, I would contact their school counselor at the secondary level, and the school counselor can walk them through one, if they have the grade to be eligible for summer school, and just what the process is.
And then general information is on the ASD website.
Yep, and that's definitely the place to go for all the generalities of locations and times and days. So
excellent.
Yep.
Anything else?
No, I think we're just excited to have our kids back. It's been a great fourth quarter seeing them in our secondary schools, and I'm excited to see them this summer as well.
Yep. Well, Dr. Johnson, thank you so much for joining us to go over virtual and in-person summer learning opportunities for secondary students. And thank you for tuning into Airplane Arms, Navigating Back to School.